screen because there are some
I could not see any timing here.
So please share your screen.
Okay.
A colored screen, either red, green or yellow.
Yeah, if you have images also, it would be nice.
Because if you show it like this, we are not able to see because we are 35 people. And the speaker is not able to see because there are so many windows. So sharing your screen is the best option.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Toastmaster, TT Master, please proceed.
Yeah. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Are you all ready for the impromptu session?
Yes.
We are ready.
Yeah, let us rock. The questions will be versatile so that you can ping me privately. I will call you one by one. Okay. Let's all start with the session. First person will be Anand C, who will be the
good
guest
evening
of today. Yeah. What are the 7 wonders of the world in your point of view? The wonders you feel that in our world, in your point of view, you can tell us.
Good evening, Toastmasters and the guest. It's like in my view, what are the 7 wonders?
7 wonders you feel, yeah.
Yeah, thank you. First wonder is mom. I believe like for it is not only for me, it's like for each and everyone. And the first wonder in this world would be the mom. For the baby, because once initially born in the due course, it just goes for feeding. And that is the first wonder. I believe like mom is the first wonder. And for every human being, and for particularly men, the daughter would be the second wonder. In your life, your life will not be fulfilled if you don't have a daughter. So I believe my daughter is the second wonder, and obviously the third wonder would be my wife, and the fourth wonder would be my son, and this like the fifth wonder would be the friends, and friend of like friends whoever we see and interact. And sixth wonder would be our neighbors, and seventh wonder would be our distance or our bosses name. See, there are like I remember a saying in the old Tamil literature, like Sitalai Shatanar and Ilongo Vadigal. The interaction with them, both even in their older age, they don't have any gray hair. It is mainly because of this all 7 things. It's like if you have a surrounding quite vibrant, quite peaceful and quite interactive, no tension from any of this, you will be looking young for a longer period of time. And I believe like Toastmaster is a forum where you see lot of good, positive and energetic people. So when you come into any Toastmaster meeting at any place, you feel the positive vibe one way or other. Where there are people like DTM Ashok Kumar who will be ready to help you for anything. And they also don't think twice of helping you. I believe like if we are into all these forum for a longer period of time, you also believe like you also stay young and stay happy. Over to you, Table Topic Master.
Yeah, thank you, Anand. Next, we are
thank you
calling Toastmaster Isabel Steffi. Isabel Steffi, are you there?
Yeah.
Who is your good luck charm and why? Who is your good luck charm and why? Hello?
Thank you. Thank you for the topic. Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. You can start.
So my topic is, who is my good luck
charm?
My topic is, who's my good luck charm?
Yeah.
I would say my good luck charm is my mother. because in all the hard times I faced in my life, she was the ray of support in my life. Be it when I was going through a tough time in college, be it when I was admitted in the hospital during my sickness, every time my mom was there, she was the ray of support in my life. And there was this particular situation. I was going through eosinophilia, and I was admitted in the hospital for a couple of days, and I really missed home food, and none of my relatives were allowed to go, stay with me in the hospital, and I really missed home food, and I kind of felt lonely at that time, because the first time I was admitted in the hospital, and there's nobody to talk to. And after that, my mom, she used to fight with the hospital employees, and she would bring lunch for me and dinner for me. Be it any time, she would be there for me. So she is my ray of support, and she is my lucky charm forever and ever. That's it. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Next, we are calling off Mr. Toastmaster Anwar. Toastmaster Anwar, are you there? Hello? Toastmaster Anwar? CMC is not there. Okay. Next, Mr. Guest, Ravi Kumar. Yes, Ravi Kumar.
Yes.
Am I audible?
Hi.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Who's the most successive person you know and why? Who's the most successive person you know and why?
Okay, in my point of view, everyone is the most successful person because everybody is struggling their problems, other things, everything. For food, for water, for daily needs. For those things, everybody is struggling. Some people, they're struggling for the money. Some people are struggling for the basic needs. So in my point of view, everybody is the most successful person in my life. That's it. What do you?
Yeah, that's it. Okay, yeah. Thank you. Then we are calling upon Toastmaster Varadarajan. Yes, Varadarajan.
Yeah, I'm there.
Yeah. Who do you admire for their perseverance? Who do you admire for their perseverance and why?
Okay, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmasters and guests. Who do I admire for their perseverance?
Yeah.
Now this topic may make me go back to my school days, because as we say in our culture, Mata Pita Guru Devam, the mother gives me birth, the father helps me values in life. But the next person, the teacher, who actually gives the direction of what to do, what not to do, which are the better things to do in life. So I go back to school, and I remember quite a lot of my teachers, but one of the my maths teacher who was very strict person, and he was like a terror. And most maths teachers are like terrors in our school days, we can remember. But this person, I still remember, because he hit me for no fault of mine. So in these type of versatile times and these type of uneven times, uncertain times, you remember these such people who have created some storm in your life. And so I immediately, when I heard your topic, I heard of my maths teacher, and I will never forget him in my life. The second important person I remember, because these people have actually not only shaped my life, but have given certain important lessons as they went along with me in my life. He was my Sanskrit teacher. We had a Sanskrit class in our school. And he was also a very strict person, and he would not accept any mistake for anything. So once I was just reciting a shloka, and I just misspelled one word. He started shouting at me as if I had created a crime. And that taught me that teachers are not only strict people, but they can also create a terror in you. But these people have not done it for their own personal purpose. They have done it for something good that you want to achieve in life. So I treasure these people. And at this point in our lifetime where we are all locked down inside, lockdown outside, the world is gone, but inside we are all open up and we are all sharing this wonderful moment. Over to the Toastmaster. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Vardarajan. Yeah, next we are calling upon DTM Mathur Sridhar. Sir, Mathur Sridhar?
Yes, am I audible? Yes, yes, audible. Yes, you get me the talk.
Yeah. Which personal trait of you has taken you to the most trouble? Which personal trait of you has taken you to the most trouble?
Being honest is something which is considered a virtue. But being honest at times and being ruthlessly honest can cause you problems. At a stage, I felt if I had not spoken the truth, I could have avoided a lot of problems. There was one instance in my life where I felt I should not have spoken the truth. And I felt that was one of the aspects really gave me pain. And that aspect is nothing but telling my company employee, that is my boss, that I'm unwell, and then giving him the real reason. I gave him the real reason by telling that I had to attend a family function and therefore I could not. I mean, the result of that was it reflected in my appraisal and I missed a promotion and I had to wait for 2 years to get another promotion. On the contrary, this is what I got by telling the truth. All my friends said, this is appraisal time. Please do not tell the truth that you have got for a family function. Instead, tell you are unwell, produce a medical certificate, and you would have got your promotion. But I was not able to do that. I spoke the truth and I felt I suffered because I spoke the truth. I missed a promotion. This is something which keeps lingering in me. Is this the price that I got for telling the truth? Is it a punishment for telling the truth? Or is my inability to handle a boss a reflection on telling the truth? This still remains a question, and this becomes a case study for me for a very long time. Over to you, table topic.
Yeah, thank you.
I always feel that telling the truth, whatever might be the reason, whether it's pleasant or unpleasant, will be worthwhile, though you could have problems. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Next, we are calling upon Sinjesh, Toastmaster Sinjesh.
Hi.
Yeah,
I'm here. Yeah. Yeah. I'm ready. Yeah, please tell.
What?
Wait a minute.
What do you miss the most when you are away from home and why? What do you miss the most when you are away from the home?
That's to me, it's a really a wonderful question, because I'm basically, yeah. I'm a Keralite and my home is in Kerala and my wife house is around 4 hours journey, around 100 kilometers away from my home, and I'm working in Chennai. So I would say mainly what I miss from my home is mainly my food, because I'm a foodie guy. And moreover to that, I have a small baby. She is just 4 years old. She is the one mostly missing to me, because in her childhood days and in this stage, since I am working here in Chennai, I'm rarely getting time to spend with her. And this, especially this lockdown period, I should have gone there and spent time with her, but unfortunately I locked down here and I could not go to my hometown. So I would say the mostly the missing thing is my daughter. So that's it. And over to you, Toastmaster.
Yeah, thank you. Next, we are calling upon Toastmaster Michael. Toastmaster Michael.
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Yeah. Which is more important for human? Intelligence or complexion? What is more important for humans? What intelligence or complexion?
Okay. So I would say, like, yeah, for a human, I would say these days it is not intelligence as well as the complexion that is required. I will say one fact that is very much required today is humanity. So that is the basic need of human. So almost all the creatures that is born in this world has got a purpose. I feel like human is all about, like, they are created to love each other's and to care for each other's. Are we really doing it? So today, everybody of us know we are in a crisis, world level crisis. So how helpful we are. So I always look at the people with a caring mindset. Okay, I always tell my mother when she prepares a grand food at home using some 4 or 5 vegetables, I will tell her, Mom, let's not do that, just take one vegetable and these days. Because I see, like, I have rushed up nearly to 10 to 5 shops today, and I have done enough searching in Wiggy and Somato, but none of them have got enough goods for people to eat. But if you have something at your home, you can use it in a little way that you can help others with humanity. So that is something which is really needed for this generation and for the humankind. If we are doing it, we are going to be a much greater souls. Of course, the intelligence is something required, but intelligence is not everything. And complexion may not be able to anybody in this universe will continue to love you, and you will become a hero for the humankind. Over to you, Dr. Master. Over to your table topic, Master Adi.
Yeah, thank you. It's echoing, so I could not hear. Next, any participants?
Yeah, Pat is there.
Yeah, sir. Who do you admire the more for their optimistic character?
I think your voice is not clear.
Yeah. Who's the most optimistic person you know and why? Who's the most optimistic person you know and why? Hello?
Yeah. Who is the most optimistic person?
And why?
For me, the person who comes right in front of me right now is the former Excellency President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Why? He's the only person, or one of the very few Indian persons, who has been able to see what can be India in future vis-a-vis the variety of other superpowers. So he paid attention to one specific area, which is called education. In the formative phase, if they are aided, guided, shaped, and sculpted properly, they are the ones who are going to lead the country. It is he who said, the real superpower India is not built in the assemblies or in the parliament. It is simply built in the classrooms of school and college. So he was full of optimism that India is going to live on the current youth. So if we can help them, guide them, and direct them in the right way, so they are going to lead us. So it is from the education point of view. At the same time, he is a person of a simplicity, humility, compassion, contribution, and helpfulness to others. So if these two qualities, that is our personal virtues, along with that, the right kind of education, we can move ahead far, far over a period of time as compared to other countries that we are seeing today. All the different parts of the world today looking for India, particularly in the medical area. It is that chloroquine, am I right? So which is being wanted by so many countries. So in my opinion, who comes to my mind is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam and his visionary qualities or the optimistic qualities. Back to the table topics, Master.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Next, we are calling upon Toastmaster Seshadri. Toastmaster Seshadri?
Yeah, I'm here, yeah.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, I have to hear you, yeah.
Yeah. How has your life made you a better person? How has your life made you a better person?
Table topic master, fellow Toastmasters and guests, good evening to everybody. Most of us always focus on what we are good at, and we normally are comfortable with what we are doing, the way we are always doing it. But always the best comes in yourself when you move out of your comfort zone. People always feel that comfort zones exist as a boundary and we don't need to cross it, and if we cross it, we'll land in trouble. If that is the scenario, if a child has been thinking that it cannot move around, it cannot sit, it cannot stand, or it cannot walk, it is not comfortable in the first place, but it will always slowly and steadily start moving its legs and hands, and it starts moving in all directions, and it starts to steady up, and it will starts moving the days to come. Similarly, in our lives also, there are stages of life where we will be feeling comfortable. But staying comfortable there alone will not help us. We need to move beyond the boundaries. Beyond boundaries in the sense that what you have not explored or what you have not tried. Always make that attempt to make what is not been your usual case and try to take the best out of the opportunity that comes to you to exhibit your extraordinary skills. Today we find that every human who is there is born at the same, to a father and a mother. And at the end of the life, we see people reach different destinations. The destination we reach is normally determined by the journey we make. Journey should always be to ensure that we achieve something beyond what we normally think that makes a person a better person. And we should always strive that we get to try things which are better off for us. Always make that extra bit of effort. Even a 100 meter race or so, if a point fraction of a second was determined as the winner, in that scenario, we also need to have the point that we stretch that extra bit so that it brings out the best in us. Over to the table topic question.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, next Toastmaster Anand Raj. Toastmaster Anand Raj?
Yeah,
if you could do something dangerous just once with no risk, what would you do and why? If you could do something dangerous just once, what would you do and why?
Can you please repeat it? If I could do something
dangerous,
not audible. Okay.
Yeah. If you could do something dangerous just once, what with no risk, what would you do and why? What would you do and why?
Okay, good evening, Toastmaster. Good evening, Debbie. I'm audible?
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, good evening, fellow Toastmasters and Table Topic Master. If I do something dangerous, in the sense, what I will do, I'll create some panic situation in the public place. If there is a good thing happening around in that place, so I'll do that panic situation that there is a something is going to happen. So people, you need to move away from this place, otherwise our life will be in trouble. So like some like something called pump hoax or something like that, I will do. I'll make an announcement that this is the dangerous situation, so people have to go away. So in that manner, I'll announce in the mic, so people will move away from the place. So it would be good for all of us. The people will also get to know the things which is going to happen in the next few minutes. So this would be the good thing. I can do it. Over to Toastmaster, Tabletopic Master.
Yeah, thank you. Next, I'm calling upon Toastmaster Murugesan. Toastmaster Murugesan, it's an off question for you. Murugesan, yeah, are you there?
I'm hearing you.
Yeah. What are the most difficult things about getting older? What are the most difficult things about getting older?
Yeah, thanks for giving us a full topic. See, yeah. I don't find any difficult things to become older. So for me, age is only by numbers. If you have the age, still you can run fast. See, there is nothing stop you. Only the mindset will stop you. I am being old, I cannot do anything. See, whether 10 years old or 90 years old, it doesn't make any difference. Only the learning capacity will be reduced because of the mindset. I have seen many people who completed their post-graduation even at the time of 50 years old. I have seen many people who are running and working for their family at the age of 70 also. See, I could show the real-time example, DDN, VN Subramanian sir. Look at his energy. Currently, he is working as a vice president and leading a leadership company. See, these people are a role model for us. See, don't worry about getting old. So only the mindset. Let us not talk about these factors. Age will not play any role for your career development. See, work on your strategy. Just to push forward. And age is, you can ensure that age is only by numbers. Wish you all the best. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. Next, any volunteers? The questions will be versatile, so any can come. Anyone?
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mr. Murugesh. Topic Master, I am volunteering. I have an only just a topic I give to myself. I joined in Toastmaster Club, Toastmaster organization in the year 1984. Most of you would not have born even at that time. So that is my experience about 36 years with Toastmaster International. Over to you, Topic Master.
So we can close now?
Yeah, final question for President of Emerging Leaders Toastmasters, Toastmaster Srivatsan. Toastmaster Srivatsan?
Can I nominate someone else?
Yeah, no, I have a special question for you. It will be older to answer for you, but it will be a question has been decided for you. I heard to know that you are a producer of Dr. Ramanujam film. Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, please describe the happiness and things which you are in your mind when you are releasing the first poster of the film. What is the mindset of you at the time.
So hello,
can you understand?
Yeah. Hello everybody. So the table topic master was describing that I had produced two films. So what was the state of my mind when I released my first film, you know, when the first poster of my film came? So first what I realized was the entire filmmaking project is no different than any other industry. It is just a project management thing. So it's a PMP thing. So how do you plan, how do you you know, take the resources and things like that. So how was my mental status? It's like writing an exam. So just before the night, you study well, and then it was as if seeing, you know, the question paper of the next day. So it is as if you are going to play your best and greatest enemy in a cricket match, or in any sport, or the most dreadful thing of what do you call? So it's like all your fears coming true. So you don't know which way it goes, whether you will fail, you will pass, or you will pass out with flying colors, or you will fail by one mark. So it's a mixed emotion. All different things go into your mind. So it's a mix of emotions, good, bad, ugly, excitement, and all that, because all the hard work that one does, you know, might just go in a flick of a switch, just like that. Either the public can accept it overwhelmingly, or they may just dismiss you like the flick of a switch. So it's no different than all of us facing in our daily lives, in our projects, in our games that we play, any sport that we play. So it's a mixed feeling to answer your question, but it was all worth it at the end of the day. Over to you, Tabletop.
Yeah. Thank you. That's all. We are coming to the end of the session. And first of all, I thought of having a poster of that film, and I thought of asking you, Mr. Srivatsan. And afterwards, the screen sharing is not allowed. One person can only share, so I can't be able to share the memes. Okay, let's concluding this session, and I hand over the stage to the team out of the day, Toastmaster Raju Rao. Thank you.
Yeah.